and Leah. Leah is a local volunteer that helps at the...
Well, not local.
Where are you from?
I'm from UK, near Bristol.
Okay. UK. Well, and you're helping out, you're helping Casper, and we're going to go and grab a
We're
going to
go and get a surfer and release it back into the ocean.
Well, let's go.
Let's do it.
Right. Okay, guys, we're heading down to the beach. Let's see, hopefully the turtle is in a good enough state that you can just release it straight away. Hopefully, if it's tired and exhausted, and if there are any other issues, the net center. Perfect. Let's see. So we're in the fishing village where all the boats come out every day and get launched to go fishing. And it's always a complex problem, you know, food security and feeding your family versus, you know, natural resources. And you know, we're getting too many, too many people, not enough space, not enough resources to sustain all of us. And that's why we have this conflict, you know. If you have your family and you have kids, you know, you'll do anything to feed them like we all would.
I can see we've just had a couple of people joining the conversation, including Stuart.
Back at the
lodge, watch out for the rope there.
Stuart, are you taking a little nap, Stuart?
Okay, he's not holding up fast.
Cool. Thanks, man. Yeah, Stuart has been fitting in long hours, you know, and...
Keep going, I'm right behind you.
Okay, cool. See the fishing net. This is a typical net that a turtle will get caught up in. So you can see it's very hard for them to.
Let's come this way.
Very hard for them to get free themselves from a net. And we're walking through here. Okay, cool guys. Mamba bibi.
Poa poa sana.
Samaki. Ah, there we go.
Oh wow.
All right, guys. So. Fakiri, tell us, quick assessment, what do you think?
Well, the turtle looks quite okay.
Looks okay, yeah. It's got the energy.
It's
not too docile.
So it's not one of the turtles that were already rescued, it's a new turtle.
It's a new one, so it's not a returning turtle.
It's not a turning turtle.
Okay, that's a good idea. Yeah. A good thing. Okay, so what are the steps from now?
Well, after assessing, we take the biometric data, that will be the length width.
Okay, so you take some measurements and...
Exactly.
So that you can identify it next time.
Exactly, and then we'll take the special ID. After that, then we'll tag the turtle and we put all the information where she was caught.
Okay.
And...
What species? We've got someone asking.
It's a hawksbill. It's a German hawksbill, yeah.
Okay, so you will actually... Andre, if you come and have a look at the bull. How cute is that turtle, man? I'm so happy that he's actually still alive and not ended up at the market, you know. So. Where are the fishermen that brought him back,
eh?
Nani, where were?
My name is Walter Alama.
Walter?
Yeah.
Walter, thank you very much for bringing this turtle back, man. We really appreciate it. And thank you for not taking it to the market to get eaten.
Yeah, okay.
Really, it's important. You know, there are not many of these turtles left.
Yeah, it's true. I don't believe and I understand.
You believe in it,
yeah,
so,
yeah,
and but you must spread the word to everyone around, you know,
okay,
that
okay.
All the other fishermen, even if they look dead, bring them here.
Okay,
bring them back and phone Fakiri and Casper and tell everyone, you know, that please, man, these turtles need all our help.
Okay.
So this is the hero of the whole story. This is the man. You are the man. Thank you. Awesome, guys. All right. Right, so Fakiri, you're going to now do your thing and take the measurements. And Andre?
Let's get around that side so we can get a...
Okay.
See exactly what Fakiri is doing, eh?
Yeah, the hero is the fisherman over there. Thank you very much. Okay. And Leo is bringing out the... The book and doing the necessary admin for free, no salary, yeah? And these guys are doing it for the greater good, and that's wonderful. How many are?
How old is he?
Yeah, how old is
he? Say again?
How many years?
How old is this turtle? Yeah. I don't know, the X's will tell us.
That's Fikiri.
Fikiri, how old is this turtle?
It's really hard to tell the precise age of the turtle.
Okay.
Because it depends where they usually forage.
Alright.
But again, you can give like an age bracket of this turtle, could be around maybe 4 to 5 years.
4 to 5 years.
Yeah.
And how old would a turtle get, or this particular species? How long will they live?
They will live 50 years plus, but with human interference that has come down.
Okay.
So maybe live 30 years.
Alright. Yeah. Okay, so the life expectancy is probably about 30 years because of trying conditions out here. And but if everything is great, you know, we don't even know how long they live, which is all the more reason why we need to do more research and just get more information about where they nest and why they nest, where and so yeah. Okay,
so that'd be interesting to know. You can see from the stuff that Leo's writing down, we take these measurements 3 times. The reason that we do that is because it's a curved surface.
Okay.
It's a curved carapace width, curved carapace length, and you take it at the longest and at the widest part. But it's quite open to, you know, you can do it. Yeah, you can do it a bit wrong.
Okay.
So if you just do it 3 times, we take the average and that gets
that
rid of
equals
that.
It all out.
Exactly. Yeah.
Very scientific.
Yeah. You know, this
well,
is
just math. Huh?
That's how it's got to be done. All right.
That's
so what's
good.
Next, guys?
Fisher's name? Walter Kalamu.
Walter.
Stuff like the location of where the turtle was caught is recorded, who caught it, the method of fishing that was used when it was ended up in a net.
Yeah.
Sometimes it ends up in, we've got different kinds of nets, there's fish traps, sometimes especially because this is a hawksbill, which is when it's a carnivorous turtle. So when they're jigging with just a hook
and a
piece of fish,
yeah.
you know, that sort of thing,
yeah.
these turtles will sometimes take
the
bait,
yeah.
and sometimes they end up with a hook in their mouth.
Okay.
Then they definitely go to a rehabilitation center, the hook
yeah.
needs to be removed.
Okay.
But in this instance, it looks like it's a pretty healthy turtle.
Okay.
So now they're going to weigh the turtle. They're placing these specially designed harnesses. And they actually, it's a design that we got from the US, but they are made here in Kenya by the A company.
Yeah, okay. Well, that's good. So there's a bit of good news in this particular case. It looks like we might just have a straight release.
Exactly, yeah. I mean, it's a critically endangered animal that was saved from being killed.
Yeah.
It's in good, healthy condition, which means that it can go straight back into the ocean by the looks of it.
So this might be that 1 out of 1,000 that might just make
absolutely,
it.
Absolutely, yeah,
and,
for sure.
You know, this might be the one, you know.
What's the reading there?
Still fluctuating. 4.730.
4.73 kilograms.
Kilograms.
Okay. Right, so
and then again,
still a baby,
yeah? Yeah, this one is still quite young. Well, say it's an early teenage
okay.
turtle, shall
right.
we say, yeah.
We'll start going out night clubbing.
And causing all sorts of trouble,
yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so again, being you know very scientific with all of this stuff, the weight was 4.730, but then afterwards we'll weigh the harness as well, because of course
okay.
the harness weighs something
yeah,
as well.
Yeah, yeah.
That's subtracted from each other, and then you get the actual weight of the turtle. Just in case people were wondering that.
Marine biologists, you know, they...
got to get our facts right, man.
Yeah, no, absolutely, man. Look at how cute that little thing is, man. And
is there anything else we should say about
yeah.
that?
Carnivorous turtle, they eat sponges a lot, actually, which is quite bizarre, because sponges have hardly any nutritional value
okay.
in them, are actually quite toxic to most animals.
and small.
But what these guys mainly eat. They eat a couple of crustaceans, you know, they'll have maybe an octopus or a squid if they can get their quick beaks on them, because they're actually surprisingly fast and agile in the water. It's incredible to see them swim.
So they all tend to
they can really move. Yeah, when they want to.
Awesome, man. All right, so a carnivorous turtle, meat eating.
Yeah.
Okay, so